Something happened. We got some people looking out.
What's going on, YouTube? We back in the Low Key Cave, Keyshawn Nimes YouTube page, aka Mr. Low Key, and we back with another TV show review, and we got BMF Episode 6, Strictly Business. To me, this was almost a standout Lamar episode. When I first seen the previews, and even when the episode first started, I was like, oh my gosh, man, they about to try to give Lamar his best Omar episode. About to try to give him his best Omar episode. Think about it. Meech them is basically Avon Barksdale, and he Omar, The Wire. But they did not go that route. And I'm glad, though, because I was just thinking, come on, what's up with the trench coat and the do-rag? That nigga ain't been wearing that since, like, the first episode. So what is this, his get-up gear when he about to go out and terrorize people? But, like I said, the closest we get to an Omar comparison is the trench coat, the do-rag, and the shotgun. That's it. He's the farthest thing from Omar. This nigga is crazy. Lamar in this episode established just how insane he is. I keep forgetting that he didn't get out of prison. Dude got out of a mental institution. I wonder if anybody else, as far as the audience, been watching this to keep forgetting that he just got out of a mental institution. It's a scene where he's talking to, he thanked that's his daughter's mother, Cash Doll's character, and dude flips out. He told some other type of shit, that crazy baby daddy type vibes, I'm telling you. But other than that, man, it seems in here where he almost on some goddamn serial killer type shit. But you know, you have those movies where you got the crazy motherfucker that's killing people, and he start doing these type of antics where like you just showing, you establishing just how crazy he is. It's a few of those moments in this episode. It's a few surprises in this episode as far as deaths, where I did not see certain deaths coming, especially at the end. I'm telling you, it's really establishing him not only as a crazy person, but Lamar is a straight-up villain. Dude is straight-up done. He out of it. And I'm telling you, this episode, he really goes there. And by the end of this episode, you are going to absolutely hate Lamar. By the end of the episode, you're going to hate him. There's certain things that I would just, because I'm going to get to everything else, but it's just Lamar, because he's the standout in this episode. I'm going to say this, though. He's a standout in a good way. He's a character that, at first, I was trying to get to a point where, is this a character that we're going to love to hate? Where you like, okay, I kind of fool with him, but I can't stand his ass. Now it's like, I can't stand him at all. I want him to go. He got to go. That's where it comes down to in this episode, man. I did miss Wood Harris in this episode. I ain't gonna lie. Wood Harris is Pat, man. He killing it. Meech and Terry, like I said, they are trying to get established, and they're trying to separate themselves, because last episode, you pretty much had the cop letting Meech know, look, we good. We done. This whole arrangement, relationship we got going on, business relationship, anything we got going on is done. It's over with. He handed him back that money, told him it's done, Felito. So now you got Meech trying to move different and stay out the way, not only because of Lamar, but because of the cop presence, because he don't have that protection no more. So they trying to move and do things different. B. Mickey and Kato. It's something that happens in this episode with B. Mickey where I'm like, oh, okay, my man, he stand on his P's and Q's. You gonna know what I'm talking about when you see the episode. But you see this relationship really, really forming between B. Mickey and Kato. And I want to tell y'all, remember something I said, because I almost thought it was going to get kind of this episode. I was like, oh, shit, we're going to get it. Nah, but I had a prediction, and I still kind of had a prediction, but after this episode, I'm kind of like, I don't know. The prediction I had was feeling like B. Mickey is going to be the one to have to take out Kato when he find out she not being loyal, but at the same time, now getting the kind of prediction. Like I said, this is not no spoilers or anything. Ain't nothing happened as far as the whole thing, as far as B. Mickey and Kato, because you know Kato been doing things for Lamar without anybody knowing. But anyway, and that's another thing. Are we sure that don't nobody know Kato got something going on? Meech is smart in the way he do, I'm telling you. But it's establishing just how B. Mickey feels about Kato and Kato about B. Mickey, because they basically falling in love, man. They falling in love. But kind of getting to that point where if Big Mickey might find something out, and Kato take might end up taking him out before he could tell Meeks and them. Like, I'm telling you, I think it's gonna be one or the other. B. Mickey gonna take out Kato, or Kato gonna take out B. Mickey. It's one or the other. But another thing in this episode is Meech and Terry trying to figure out ways to move product, get certain things done without being caught up with Lamar and without being caught up with the police. And now you have a point where, because B. Mickey has been wanting to kind of get in on the fold as far as being partners with Meech and Terry, because if you know, B. Mickey been around pretty much since the beginning, since Meech and Terry started, especially with Meech. So now you get in that point where he's trying to get established on his own. And I think Meech is kind of leaning towards it, but Terry on the other end doesn't see him as an equal to him and Meech. That's how Terry is looking at it. He's like, I don't see him like that. But Meech, I feel like, is kind of leaning towards it because he's like, he's loyal. He been holding it down. And you can see where that's coming from as far as Meech, because Meech is a guy that is built on loyalty. He really vibes off loyalty. And I feel like Terry is more, I ain't gonna say more business-minded, but he has a way he wants to deal with certain things. And that's why he doing the things he's doing with the new plug or whatnot. But Terry is also trying to establish things outside of the streets as far as school. He is trying to get himself together, still do the school thing. But you can't do both. And in this episode, like I said, you have everything going on with their mama. You know, their mama found out about everything, which, I mean, come on. The daddy pretty much already knew. And they daddy, he's still kind of going through it in this episode. But he getting some things done, and I feel like he's trying to come around as far as his family. The only thing with the daddy is, it's like he is done with Meech. Dude, man, it's like, he all Terry. Everybody is like Terry, 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 Terry. And it's like, when it come to Meech, you're like, nah, Meech is done. Meech is gone. I'm like, damn, they both y'all sons. Come on now. And I feel like the mama do be trying, but the daddy is done. Like, what happened to my man off Lincoln Heights? Like he wouldn't have gave up on nobody that quick. You know what I'm saying, man? But like, bro, I'm telling you, Snoop Dogg, man. I was kind of iffy on Snoop Dogg being this preacher role or whatnot. I thought it was going to be kind of silly, or they was going to try to be extra with Snoop or whatnot. My bad, y'all. I'm trying to make sure. Okay. But I just felt like it was kind of going to be extra, but it's not. It's actually humorous as hell, but not. Snoop Dogg is not playing it like in a spoof type of way. He's playing it like this real shady-ass preacher. Straight up, and he playing it. I'm actually with it, and I'm going along with it the more and more they do it. And whatever they got Snoop going on, it's funny too. But it's not funny where it's like, man, look at Snoop trying to play this preacher. It's funny as if this shady-ass preacher keep trying to do these certain things. And it's a scene with him and the daddy, because you know the daddy don't like the preacher anyway. It's a scene with him. I'm not going to say what it is, but it's funny. It is a small scene, but it's funny the way Snoop go about it. Because it's like, bro, what is you doing, man? And I'm going to say this. I know I'm calling him Snoop, but I don't see him as Snoop in this series. I don't. Like, the first time he came around, I was kind of like, okay, we got Snoop with this pastor. But once he started talking and doing what he doing, it seemed like this is just shady, just a shady pastor. That's all, just a shady pastor. And with the scenes he does have in this episode, I'm with it, man. I love the scenes he had in this episode. Not just with the daddy, but with the other dude, the dude that Lamar choked out. Speaking of him, he's pretty much done got to that point where, like I said, he's a guy that's from business. The guy, I can't remember his character's name, but the guy that Lamar choked out last episode, that was sitting in the car with Meech at the end of the last episode, basically telling him, I don't care about no loyalty, none of that other, all the above, it's all about business with me. Hey, pretty much have a revelation in this episode with Lamar. And it's pretty much letting people know, like, they just like, no, nigga, you crazy. We can't rock with you, you crazy. And I don't know what it is, but Lamar just cannot stand light-skinned niggas. He cannot stand light-skinned dudes, man. But like I said, and I'm going to keep emphasis on this, this episode in particular established not only just how crazy Lamar is, but just how much of a villain he is. Dude do not care. He do not care. And it really sets up this episode. This episode got dark at the end, bro. It did for me. It got dark at the end. And you don't know what I'm talking about, man. I was like, I didn't think he, I mean, I know he was not right in the head, but damn, the extent he went to, and I'm like, whoa. Yeah, we got to get him up out. He got to go. If anybody got to go in this series, he got to go, man. But, damn, he damn near gave me Candyman vibes in this episode. I'm telling you, you're going to understand when you watch the episode, man. But overall, man, I pretty much think that was everything as far as just how everything went as far as this episode, as far as my review and my opinion on how this episode went. It's still a good episode, and I feel like this episode was even better than the last couple episodes as far as taking it to a darker tone, in my opinion. It went there. I'm telling you, you're going to know what I'm talking about when you watch the end of this episode, man. And to me, it went to that next level. It almost went to a level that I haven't seen really like a power do besides, you know, Tyreek's sister being killed. Other than that, though, this episode, I'm telling you. But it really is not only that, this series overall could put Lamar up there with kind of those villains that you really not, you hate, but you still can't wait to see what he gonna do next. I'm telling you, for real, it was that type of episode tonight. But other than that, man, this episode pretty much is establishing the way Meech thinks as far as keep letting you know just how smart and just how much of a thinker and a maneuver he is as far as the way he is as a leader and doing certain things. It also shows you just how much Terry is he's in the loop, but just how much that he is trying to move with the streets, do what he's doing in the streets, but also try to keep up with his education, which is a good thing because it's establishing just how smart both of them are as brothers. Not only that, though, it also keep establishing their bond. Once again, a shout out to Little Meech playing Big Meech and his acting. The chemistry between not only the family, but the brothers is all there, man. Shout out to the sister, too. I can't think of the actress playing the sister, but she has a really good scene in this episode. She has a standout scene. She does something kind of stupid in this episode, but she's a kid playing a kid, and I feel like that was the reason is behind that part. But other than that, man, that was pretty much my review of episode 6, Strictly Business, BMF season 1. Y'all let me know in the comment section how y'all feeling about this latest episode. Did it take it there for you? Did it establish this Lamar as a real true villain in this episode? How did y'all feel about everything that happened in this episode? The only problem I had with this episode that we didn't get enough Wood Harris and Steve Harris, the brothers. We didn't get enough of the cop, and we didn't get enough of Pat. That's the only thing, because I love seeing them, and I love the episodes. I really hope that we get another episode with both of them in it. That last episode with both of them in it, man, I'm telling you, I love that. That was my favorite scene from that episode. But overall, though, man, y'all let me know in the comment section how y'all feeling about this latest episode of BMF. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. This is the road to 400 subs. Shout out to all my subscribers. And shout out to everybody that's been checking out my videos, man. We out.
I know you wanted the gateways to Detroit.
Think you're going to take over the world?
Hell yeah.